Welcome to GYS. How are you? I hope you are doing well. So friends, as you know that on our channel, we are covering the syllabus of UPSC Civil Services. And for this purpose, we have started MCQ series of different topics like Ancient India, Medieval India, Modern India, Environment and Ecology, etc. So what we are doing in this series, friends, let me tell you that we cover daily 5 questions. And in this way, we cover the 5 questions of each topic. That is of the, all the topics, that is like Ancient India, Medieval India, Modern India, Environment India. And we will continue to do so till 31st May. So why the date chosen has been 31st May? Because on 2nd June is your prelims, and we will end this series only one day before your prelims exam. So in this way, you can imagine that with how much practice you will be going to your exam hall if you follow these series daily. Because approximately, if you go by calculation, 1100 to 1200 questions of each topic we would have covered. So stay tuned with us if you want to be confident in your prelims exam if you want to clear it with great margin. So let's start our discussion, friends. The first question is Kabir's teaching rejected. The first statement is all forms of external worship. Second is preeminence of the priestly class. Third is order of the caste. So we have to choose the correct statement. So let me tell you, friends, that Kabir was a bhakti saint in medieval India. So there were very great number of bhakti saints about which you have heard, the Mirabai of Rajasthan, and also multiple. There were also like Guru Nanak in Punjab region. So there were multiple. So they rejected. So the Kabir rejected all these things. So the correct option is D. So let me provide you the explanation that Kabir's teaching, the teachings of the Kabir completely rejected all these traditions. He openly ridiculed the external form of worship, whether it was in Hinduism or it was in Islam. So he also opposed the caste system. He also opposed the priestly classes of that time. So basically, he believed in a supreme God. So according to him, the only path to salvation was complete devotion to one supreme God that is formless. So his followers from among both the Hindus and Muslims. So this is about the first question. So before moving on to second question, let me tell you, friends, that earlier we used to provide the explanation of all the questions, but now we provide the explanation of only first question, and from now onwards you will be provided the solution only of 4 questions, that is 2nd, 3rd, 4th, 5th. So why this has been done? Because our paid subscribers are requesting that there must be a certain kind of difference between free subscribers and the paid subscribers, and for that reason we have introduced a change in our policy. So you will get the explanation of first question only, so that you might have idea that what type of initiative this is, whether it is of UPSC level or not. So by seeing the question and seeing the explanation, you will have the idea, and by seeing all the video lecture, you can get idea that whether we are following the UPSC pattern or not. So if you want the complete explanation of all the question, you can subscribe to our initiative. We have kept this initiative very affordable. It is just ₹100. You have to just pay ₹100 for this initiative of Medieval India. That means you will be getting 1100 to 1200 questions and just ₹100. All the explanations will be given. So let's start the second question. First question, the first statement is the Mughal school of painting originated in the reign of Akbar. Second is the Western Indian style of painting is the only style uninfluenced by infusion from foreign style. So friends, let me tell you that first statement is correct, that Akbar was a great patron of art and architecture. So while earlier he was busy in his political consolidation of the empire, but when he got the free time, he kind of hired artisans and also multiple different type of craftsmen, and he took them to the Fatehpur Sikri, the new capital, where he engaged them in different type of activities like paintings and architectural, etc. So the first statement is correct, but regarding the second statement is incorrect, friends, because Western Indian style of painting was influenced and it was influenced in great deal by the foreign style, that is by the Persian style, the Safavid school of paintings. So the second statement is incorrect. So only the first statement is correct. So the A option is correct. So the solution is A. But the complete explanation is provided only to our paid subscribers. So let's move on to third question. Which of the following is incorrect about the Mughal school of painting? So friends, today I have included mostly the lectures about the painting and Mughal school. I have included questions about culture. So let's see which of the following is incorrect about Mughal school of painting. A is it does not portray naturalistic themes. B is it is aristocratic and secular in nature. C is it is closely influenced by Persian school of painting. D, none of the above. So let me tell you friends that the A statement is incorrect. So why it is incorrect, that will be in the explanation part. But yes, it was aristocratic and it was secular and it was completely influenced by the Persian school of painting. So there was a kind of mixture of Persian school of painting and Indian school of painting. Because the Akbar hired the professionals from Persia itself to teach the Indian painters in the painting. So that's why it was closely influenced by Persian school of painting. So the solution is A and the explanation is provided to paid subscribers. So this is the next question is, what is the major theme running common between the Central India and Rajasthani school of painting? So friends, during the medieval India, there were certain regions which gained importance in terms of culture, in terms of we can say that art, and that were central regions and the Rajasthani school of painting. And we have been asked here to identify the major theme that was common in them. So A option is they are deeply rooted in Indian traditions. B is they are highly secular in nature. C is they are unaffected by the historical developments and carry a unique style. D is they use light colors to portray extra terrestrial dreams. So friends, let me tell you that they were deeply rooted in Indian traditions. So the painters in the Rajasthani school or the central Indian schools, they were completely influenced by the Indian epics like Mahabharata and others like Puranas and Ramayana, and they depicted the scenes in their paintings also. So this is the correct explanation. So the A is the correct option, that the major theme running between them was they are deeply rooted in Indian traditions. So explanation is the correct option is A, and the explanation is provided to only our paid subscribers. So lastly friends, comes your last question. Consider the following statements. Assertion is Mughal painting reached its zenith under Aurangzeb, and the reason is Aurangzeb came into contact with European painters who he contracted to further enrich Mughal paintings. So friends, let me tell you that both the statements are incorrect, because friends, Aurangzeb was a kind of ardent follower of Islam, and in Islam it is considered unlawful to kind of depict the nature, because it is the creativity of God, and it is considered that if you depict the God, then you are trying to kind of, if you kind of paint the nature, then you are we can say that you are trying to become like a God, which you can't become. Under Aurangzeb, the Mughal painting doesn't reach zenith. In fact, the decline had set in. So the A is also incorrect and the R is also incorrect. So both the statements are incorrect. So the D option is correct. So here, further explanation about this, that how this ultimately declined and what was the role of Aurangzeb in it, and how it rose to eminence. All these things are provided in the explanation PDF, which is available to our paid subscribers. So if you want to become our paid subscriber, you can WhatsApp us at this number, that is 8968426481. So we are covering daily 5 questions of each subtopic, so approximately, and we will cover till 31st May. So approximately 1100 questions will be covered of each topic. And friends, let me tell you that these are not just 1100 questions, these are in fact 4000 questions. Because in our explanation PDF, we tell you that why a particular answer is correct and why the other options are incorrect, and what are the correct alternatives of that. So in a way, in one question you cover 4 topics. So approximately if you subscribe to these PDFs, you will get 4000 concepts. So 4000 concepts are quite a big number. So you will be very confident about your topic if you follow these series regularly and subscribe to our PDF. So friends, for the purpose of your affordability, we have not kept much fees. We have just kept rupees 100 for the entire course of MCQs of Medieval India. That means you will have to make a single time payment of rupees 100, and you will get all the 1100 questions in this just rupees 100. So there are other courses as well about which let me explain to you the other courses. There is environment course and for the PDFs of it we are charging rupees 50. There is ancient India, we are charging 100 for this, and medieval India we are charging 100, and modern India also we are charging 100. So the total amounts to rupees 350. So friends, those students who are subscribing to all these PDFs in a package form, for them we are offering a discount of rupees 75. That means they will get all these PDFs in rupees 275. So if you consider 1100 questions of each topic and you multiply it with 4, then you will be getting 4400 questions in just rupees 275. And if you further include the concepts, then the concepts, if you multiply by each question, in each question you will be getting 4 concepts. And if you multiply by 400 even by 3 concepts, then you will get how much number? 3 for 12 13. You will be covering this much number of concepts. So you how can not be your explanation, your kind of coverage will not be comprehensive. It will be obviously comprehensive, because friends, ultimately in your UPSC, the main things matter are the basic concepts, the important concepts, the revision, and the revision also multiple times and with minimum time consumption. So friends, basic concepts are covered in NCRTs, so you can read them one or two times. After that they become monotonous, and also it becomes time waste of time. And also friends, important books concepts can be covered from the standard books, and also they can be at the most we can read them at the most 2 times. After that they also become monotonous, and it becomes a waste of time to read them again and again. So friends, it is not possible to read them again and again. But yes, it is important to revise. Then how to revise? The question arises, then how to revise? Friends, this MCQ pattern, that is question answer pattern, in which a certain question is asked and the answer is provided, this provides you interest. Because when you see question, then you will also see the answer, that what is the answer and why a particular option is answered and the other is not. So then you will follow the revision in an interesting manner. And when you do a thing in an interesting manner, you find interest in it, you do it multiple times. And when you do it multiple times, you face confidence, you feel confidence, and it consumes your less time. And in this way, you prepare for the UPSC in an effective way. So let me tell you friends, if UPSC is 100%, 30% is reading part and 70% is revision part. So don't ignore this revision part. And I am telling you, I have a 5-year experience in this field, that if you don't revise, then you are wasting your time. Revision is most important thing in the UPSC. If you are reading one thing, and if for example I am not able to remind the kind of a thought of a person, but he used to say he is a boxer, but I am not able to recall his name. So he said that instead of practicing 10 shots, I will practice one shot and I will practice it 10 times so that I will become perfect in it. So in this way, this is what the UPSC is. You will have to revise the topics, you have to cover them comprehensively, and you have to cover them again and again. So friends, lastly friends, if you want, let me tell you that we have a Telegram channel also, the link of which I have provided in the description box. So if you want to join our Telegram channel, you can check the link in the description box and can join the Telegram channel. But friends, those students who don't know how to join it, let me tell you that there is an app called eSandesh that is available on the Play Store. So it is an unofficial app of your Telegram, and it is totally free of cost. You can download it, and it is available on Google Play Store as well as App Store. So when you will download it, you will see search box, and what you have to do, you have to just copy and paste the link here, and in this way you can join to my channel. So friends, let me tell you that there is no cost of downloading this app as well as joining this channel. So if you want to remain tuned with us, remain updated with us, you can join our channel. And friends, this is all about today's lecture. If you liked it, please like it, please share it with your friends, and please friends, do subscribe to our channel, and please don't forget to press the bell icon, because only in this way you will get all the notifications of all the initiatives that we are running. So thank you friends. Thank